Last time that you and I spoke on the air
was
the day that we found out that Disney had purchased Lucasfilm.
Yep, that's right.
And that was back on the Toad Hop days on the Schmoes No Show. And we were going to have you on for one particular thing, and then the news broke, and then we were just talking and speculating about Star Wars for like 2 hours. It was a blast.
Yeah.
And then years passed, and I'm playing Battlefront 2. And I'm like, wait a minute. I look at I hear the credits, and Mr. Matt Mercer did the voice for Luke Skywalker.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me about that one, though, too, because I mean, obviously from that conversation we had talking Star Wars, you're a big fan of Star Wars, but not only anytime you get a role in Star Wars, whatever it might be, you get excited, but when they say, oh, yeah, and it's Luke Skywalker, how much pressure goes into that?
A lot of pressure. Yeah. I mean, a lot of excitement. It's a very unique honor to do that, especially when it was performance capture. So getting to actually perform the character and, you know, walk alongside an R2-D2, technically, though it's just a push chair in the middle of a, motion capture volume. But being able to pull a lightsaber out and do combat aspects and kind of embody a character that I grew up with was huge. It was so cool and a lot of pressure.
Well, what do you do as far as that? Because, obviously, your ears are tuned in. Does that sound like Luke? Does that sound like what do you do? Do you go back and just rewatch all the movies, because the Mark Hamill today, so 65 years old or whatever he might be, or younger, sounds very differently than the character that you were playing. And when you go back, do you listen to the original trilogy to kind of just get his voice right?
And for that one in particular, well, that was Return era. So going back to that specific, because he's changed dramatically from film to film, and so that's a little more of the true Jedi, a little more of the centered Luke than the previous films. So it's taking a lot of that inspiration, but also allowing a little bit of yourself. You're trying to do Luke, but you also want to kind of make it a little bit your own in a subtle way, at least
of course,
depending on the director. Some directors like, make it exactly, but they were also interested in kind of bringing a little bit of the Mercer flavor to it. But for me, it was just trying to do my best to pay homage to that character.
Well, you're certainly allowed to do, you should be able to do that, because the fact is that Mark Hamill had his idea of what Luke was during Jedi, but then that character obviously changed after that. So the actor playing him, even though you want to get his voice right, you should have your own ideas with guidance from the director of where the character went and how he would be and what he's been doing now that you've been given those tools to figure that out.
Yeah, it's been great. And I've done a couple other things that, like the fact that I get to step into Luke's shoes more and more as the years go on is really cool.
And you played a bunch of other iconic characters too. I think you've done Captain America, Iron Man, apart from all, your anime and video game voiceover, is there one that related to that was more challenging, or is there one that you really loved and that you would like to go back to?
Oh, man. For me personally, growing up a huge Resident Evil fan, stepping into the shoes of Leon Kennedy was a huge, huge honor for me, and equally intimidating also.
Right.
So that was huge. I would love to be able to go back to that. I've done a few of the animated or the CG features, and as a character that's just really close to me. But
well, Ken, I know that before we jump away from the Star Wars, because you get something going on.
I'll give it of my book, Why We Love Star Wars, coming out May 15th. Yeah. One of the essays is about the core of Luke Skywalker's character in the scene on Pilio in the Battlefront story mode, where Luke and Delmico connect, and it's post Jedi, and it is Luke discovering who he is as a Jedi, and it's one of the best Luke moments in all of Star Wars. And I got to listen to you one day on repeat. 200 times. I get to hear your...
I'm so sorry.
It was like old times, but you guys really did a great job of connecting and finding. So whatever you found, because it's there.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
It's really good, and it's some of best Luke Skywalker stuff out there.
And to give some context to that, I've known Ken for close to a decade now.
Yeah.
We've collaborated on a lot of projects, so the fact that you then, on top of that, forced yourself to listen to me on repeat, I genuinely apologize for it.
No, it was great. It was sweet.